Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. Today, I want to go over how to fix a table that has irregular table rows and columns. I have a sample PDF here that is currently failing from an error in the accessibility checker called table regularity. This means there's an issue with the amount of data cells and header cells for a given row, and we're going to try a couple of different methods to fix this problem. But before we get to that, take a second to hit that subscribe button. Now back to the video. So the first thing I want to do is actually open up the tags panel. And what I can determine in this table is that our very top table row has two heading tags. The next table row has four TD cells. The next row has a table header and four TD cells. And finally, we have a table header and four TD cells. The first thing I'm going to do is actually update row number two to also be table headers. So I'm gonna select all of those cells, right click, select properties, and using the drop-down menu, I'm going to select table header cell and then select close. Now let's see if we can figure out how to fix this table regularity. I'm going to open up the accessibility button and then choose the reading order tool. Then I'm going to right click inside the table and select table editor. Next, I need SJC to be the header for both produced and sold on this first and second row. So I'm gonna right click SJC, select table cell properties, and then I want to ensure that I have header cell and column selected, and then I'm gonna change the column from 1 to 2 and select okay. And I'm going to do the same thing for SJIS, select table cell properties, change it to a header cell column span 2, and select OK. And then let's go ahead and run our accessibility checker one more time. And it looks like we still have a little bit of work to do. So let's open up the reading order tool once more, right click, select table editor. And what we need to do is the issue right now is we have 4 cells in the second row and 5 cells in the third and fourth row. So I need to ensure that produced is set to column and it has the span of 2. So let's right click produce, select table cell properties, and I'm going to ensure that header cell is selected, column is selected, and then I want to check column span 2 and select okay. And now let's run the accessibility checker and see what results we get. All right, since I'm still getting a failure, what I realized is I was setting SJC and SJIS to column span 2 and 2, which covers 4 cells, but there's actually 5 in the document. So I need to make sure one of my headers has a column span of 3 because it's going to include hold, produced, and then documents and videos. So I'm gonna right click SJC, select table cell properties, and set my column span to 3, and then select okay. Now I'm going to run the accessibility checker and that finally has cleared my regularity. So anytime you have a table that has cells that span more than one column, it's important that you adjust the column scope and span to ensure that it's including all of the columns for that particular heading. There's actually one other method to fix this table regularity problem. I'm going to open up the same exact sample file and run it again. Now, this specific option doesn't work every single time, but let's expand the tags window and open up the table once more. And what we're going to do is we're going to ensure that every row has 5 cells. And currently, the very top row is missing 2 cells. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add in 2 TD cells in the top row. And then let's delete out this blank P tag from both of those rows. So now each row has 5 items in it. Let's go ahead and change these blank tags back to TDs instead of THs. And now let's run the accessibility checker again. And that also will clear the table regularity. Now, this totally depends on what accessibility standard you are going towards, and different accessibility standards have different rules for whether or not you can use the blank cells in these particular situations. Now, it's also important that you still set the scope and the span for these header tags and make sure you connect your associated header IDs to ensure that your table is completely accessible.